This is a quick look at Pixel's Touch Sprite Maker by YouZodiac. It's basically, as the title suggests, it's a sprite maker or a pixel art editor or low resolution image picture creator, whatever you want to call it. It's for creating low res images. This is one I've created recently, which is of a video game called Afterburner. Not everyone will know what I'm on about, but that's the sort of thing I like to do with it. You can use it for creating characters, that sort of thing, so it's quite a useful tool. And it's got all the basic sort of drawing options, so if I just create a new file, so I can do it here as well, just click the new button and set the size. The maximum size I think is 512 by 512, so obviously low resolution. I'm just going to do 32 by 32. And you can zoom in and out using this sort of scroll bar here, quite handy. You can draw with a pen, make sure you've got the pen highlighted, pick a colour from your palette down the bottom, and obviously you can sort of draw whatever you want, and obviously if you want to make it really accurate, you could zoom in. While zoomed in, you can use this pan tool here, sort of move around the image, and you can fill in using different colours. So if I pick that blue from the palette there, I can fill that in. But it's sort of standard stuff you'd get with a typical image editor. And you've got the eyedropper tool, so you can pick a colour. So if you forgot what colour you used, you could just sort of click on that, click on that colour there, and it sort of matched it. Then go back to the pen tool, and you can sort of draw whatever you want from there. We've got a highlight tool there, so I can highlight this area. While highlighted, you can zoom in and out, and obviously you've still got the pan tool there, so you can move around. You can flip the image one way or the other, and you can either X to cancel what you're doing, tick to go ahead with whatever you've done. If we go, like I could, if I take that off, I can move that around now like that, or I can copy it and move a copy somewhere. Obviously you might want to pan out to move it to somewhere else, and if you're happy, click tick. If you're not, you click no. So I'm going to click tick just for the sake of showing how it's done. We've got a little option here that shows the grid, which helps you sort of separate the pixels. Might be helpful for lining up stuff. You've got this little button here that shows like a very small version, that's probably actual size, of the pixels that you're drawing. I don't really use that. And there's an option here that sort of splits the image in two, so you can see sort of half brightness. Not quite sure what use that is. Maybe someone else finds that useful, probably for perhaps creating icons. I don't know, actually, to be honest. And then you've always got your eraser tool, so I can... Oops, I'm still on highlight there, so... go back to the pen. On a razor, so now I can rub stuff out like that. Obviously, if you, you've got undo and redo there. And if you want to pick a colour, down the bottom, you hold your finger on that sort of main swatch, and you get like a colour mixer here, which is quite useful. So I can now mix up a new colour. And here's my palette. You can obviously have more palettes, but on this particular palette, I just pick a little spot there, and I say set. And the colour I've picked then goes in that spot. So if I go to pink and I want it in that one, so set. And if I'm happy, I say choose. And then that takes me back to where I was, and you can see those colours have now been added. And that's pretty much it. It's brilliant, it's free. Obviously, the advert, it hasn't displayed, but the advert normally displays up the top there. There you go. An advert displays up the top there, which really doesn't bother you while you're drawing and stuff. And we've also got this switch option here, so you can mix your colours up that way around. And yeah, that's pretty much it. You can save down here using your sort of menu button. And yeah, it's a good app.